So what's up guys, I'm actually at Olympus Coliseum right now. I wanted to get a little bit of work done before I started working out. But I want to answer a few questions too. Quick ones. Someone asked me what camera and lens I'm using. I'm using a Sony A5100 with an FE2-28 lens. It was recommended to me by Raymond the Online Coach, and you've seen his videos, you have seen his pictures. That answers that question. The body cost me about $370. The lens was about $450, maybe $500, somewhere around there. With warranties and everything, it was almost about a grand. But the camera quality is good. The lens is great. The build is good. It feels great. It's small enough that I can carry around, and it's convenient. So if you do want to pick it up, I recommend it. Although I am not the foremost expert on cameras. So do your research. Secondly, someone asked if I own this gym, Olympus Coliseum. Okay, no, I do not own this gym, although I do want to own one in the future. It's a personal goal of mine. But yeah, I don't own this gym, I just work out here. Donna's gonna be here soon. Like I said, I'm gonna be getting a push workout in. I'll be explaining all that to you guys. I'm repeating myself. I'll see you soon. I ended up dragging on my work a little bit longer than I wanted to. So I have about an hour to get in a workout. I'm going to be max testing my close grip bench press. So like I did with the other day, with my pull workout, the Smith Machine barbell row, I'm going to be working up to a fairly heavy weight. And then when I get to a place where I think, okay, let's say I did 225 for 5 reps, or let's say I did 225 for 7 reps, I was like, okay, I had maybe 3 reps left in the tank. I'm then maybe gonna just jump myself up to 260 or 275 and do as many reps as possible. Hopefully I can't do like 6 or 7 of those. But then using a max rep calculation, I will be able to see what my max is for my close grip bench press. And then that's gonna be my main pushing movement that I'll be progressing. I feel like this workout, have an hour, I'm going to rush through these close grip bench presses. I'm probably going to do one arm dumbbell overhead presses because that's a shoulder movement I wanna progress. Maybe some incline presses. This is just off the top of the head. It's probably gonna change. For my main hamstring movements, I'm gonna do dumbbell RDLs and glute ham raises because we have a glute ham raise machine here. But the way I'm gonna progress my glute ham raise is initially I'm going to use nothing. It's gonna be progressed in a higher rep range within 12 to 15. And I don't know if I wanna use, I think I'm gonna use weights instead of bands just because for progressing like a glute ham raise, it's easier to progress with weight because with bands you can't really, you don't know like, oh okay, how do I get 5 more pounds of resistance? But if you're like you did glute ham raise and then you were able to do 3 sets of 15, then you grab a 5-pound plate, put that on your chest or dumbbell, it's a better structured progression. This isn't even prep brain, guys. When I was in prep, I was so slow. Anyway, let's go. Close grip bench press pro tip. Hopefully I'm not too close for you to notice what I'm doing. Okay, so I have talked to people who have said that they cannot feel the close grip bench press in the triceps a lot. Now when most of these people close grip bench press, and even when they bench press, when they're here at the bar, this is gonna be a very common theme. When they're here with the bar, right? They're just pushing up and down. And if you notice, when you come down and you're just pushing, the elbow is out here, right? Now, if you actually rewind and watch the close grip bench press, you'll notice that I go like this, and then I imagine I break the bar. Elbows come underneath right here. So when I'm coming down, boom, most of the tension stays in the tricep. I honestly don't feel a lot of close grip bench press in my chest because of this, but if I were just to come straight down and straight up, I'll feel a little bit in my tricep and quite a bit in my chest. So, to feel the close grip bench press, mainly in your triceps, make sure that when you grab this bar, hopefully you see this, make sure that when you grab this bar here, and then you're not just coming down like this, you break the bar, you're almost up here, and you're here instead of here. Okay? When max testing, I do not advise you to make a 60-pound jump in weight, which is what I'm doing right now. Went from 225 to 285, I'm gonna do an AMRAP with 285. Hopefully I do not fail. I'm hoping to get maybe 3 or maybe 4 reps. If I barely get one, then I have horribly failed. But I'm doing this because I have to rush, guys, and I wanna get you most of this workout. I'll explain my setup for this in another video. Success, okay. That was a bloodshot. So, I got 5 reps. If I had a spotter, I think I could have potentially gotten a 6th. So, when I do input this into my max calculator, instead of saying I got 5 reps, I'm gonna go for 6. Because I think I could have turned out that 6th one. I just didn't want to risk it. Because if I did, I wouldn't be alive to post this video. When I'm dumbbell overhead press is next. I'm actually gonna have the full-on overhead press in my split. Right now I'm thinking no. I have to actually sit down and write things out to see how things look on paper, see if it's possible. But I think that'll be too many compound pushing movements, especially since I really want to concentrate on my close grip bench press. And if I do the overhead press, it'll be too much volume taken away from what I could press with my close grip. So this is just me not writing it on paper, just thinking of why I wouldn't want to do it. But who knows, maybe when I get things written out, I could fit in some space for full-on military press. But my substitute for the barbell overhead press will be the one-arm dumbbell overhead press, which I love. I freaking love this movement. Happy to see. Pro tip, whenever you're doing a one-arm dumbbell overhead press, or even a strict military press, and there are actually a lot of movements that you should probably do this little thing with, I'm not gonna zoom in on my ass because I don't wanna show you my ass. What you need to do is flex your glutes, okay? Shit, whatever. So, when doing this kind of movement, if you're not flexed here, right? And you're just pressing up here, and your glutes are kind of loose, you will actually probably have a shit ton of thoracic extension like this because your glutes aren't being utilized to keep you in place. Now, if you're not bracing also, you're gonna have a ton of thoracic extension, which is not safe when doing any type of pressing movement, but this is gonna help to mitigate that. It's one thing that's gonna help mitigate that. So, when you're doing things like a bench press, a close grip bench press, a military press, a dumbbell overhead press, even a bicep curl or lateral raise. I could name so many workouts. Make sure that your glutes are flexed. Your hips are in full extension. It's much safer that way. Another fault. Now, this comes into the idea of bracing, right? When you're doing an overhead press, a dumbbell overhead press, or a military overhead press, right? Make sure, you'll see this happen a lot to people. They'll be here, they'll press, and then they'll go like this, and they'll come back. I exaggerated that a lot, but they'll be here with an overhead press, they'll press, and then you'll see their thoracic spine round, and then they'll come up. Extremely unsafe. Now, whenever I do any type of these pressing movements, another thing I think about is this. Pelvis, okay, pelvis, rib cage. Think of your pelvis and your rib cage as two bowls pouring right into each other, right? So, when I flex my glutes and my hips come from here to here, that's one bowl. And my rib cage, right? Instead of it being open like this, I'm right here, pelvis is here. That's why we notice me pressing, I focus on bracing and keeping myself in this position so I don't have that open fault. Those two things, flexing your glutes and then keeping your pelvis above your rib cage, even with a deadlift, squats, overhead presses, anything, will keep you so safe. So safe. Let's get another set in. Last set of 12. Clock is running, so I don't have much time to think. So I think I'm gonna have incline bench presses as another pressing movement that I wanna progress. It's been a really long time since I've done any type of dumbbell chest work. My last cycles of training for literally the past 9 months. Actually, no, more than that. From November or October of last year, I haven't done any dumbbell incline movements, so my dumbbell pressing is weak. My bench press got stronger, but my dumbbell pressing is weak. I did, although, see a lot of gains in my chest from just doing the bench press. So, that just shows you the power of compound movements, but isolation movements also have their place. And they can also help you gain lots of muscle. I mean, in my earlier years of training, I mainly did dumbbell bench work instead of doing the bench press, which is why my bench press is so weak for my size, to gain my size in my chest. So let's not just say that compound movements are the king, but I'm rambling, let's go. A bad idea. Okay. Because I did dumbbell overhead pressing and it was fairly heavy, those felt like shit. Also, I mean, my dumbbell presses are much weaker nowadays. I used to press like 100s or 110s, but now 85 for 12 is difficult. Granted, I just did a lot of pressing movements, but I think a much better idea for this then is if I'm gonna feel like that after doing those two movements, we're gonna do lighter weight and stick these in a higher rep range, or I might actually just change these to dumbbell inclined flies. I'm not gonna do that now since I'm lacking the time, but that's an idea. I'm doing really stupid things in this workout. I didn't give myself enough rest after my last set for that set. That was 65s, guys. That's light. Even for a lot of you guys that are like 180, 170, that's light for you guys. Anyway, I'm not drinking any water right now, so I gotta go grab it, but I need more rest. Definitely need more rest in between my sets. So like I said, I'll take you through the process. Decision made. I'm gonna change it from doing incline bench presses to flat dumbbell bench presses. Reason being, I'm already attacking my delts by doing one-arm dumbbell overhead presses. I'm already slightly attacking my bench by doing close grip bench presses. I'm also gonna be doing lateral raises after this. So it doesn't really make sense to do incline bench presses or incline dumbbell presses because it's part delt, chest, upper chest. It just makes more sense to utilize my chest more since it hasn't been used through most of this workout. So flat dumbbell bench presses it is. Flat dumbbell bench presses it is. This reminds me of Goldilocks. Remember that story? I think there were three beds. One was too hot, one was too cold, and one was just right. We're trying to figure out what's just right. Donna.
Yeah?
Goldilocks and the Three Bears was about three beds, right? Or was it like soup? Or was it porridge? It was porridge?
It's a bed and a chair and porridge.
It's a bed and chair and porridge. I forgot the story.
It's what you do, not what you did. Boy grew up from a kid, never knew what it is, was, or gonna be. So if you don't live life humbly, you might feel the sting of a bumblebee. You tried it before, but don't.
I think that's the one. But I think I've tortured my chest a little bit too much with testing out weights that I won't be able to do two more sets of that, which is actually what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna be doing two sets of 12 at 85. Next week I'll do two sets of 90 at 10 reps. What I said's kind of confusing, but I'll go over it in another video. I think now I'm gonna go over to kettlebell lateral raises, and then I may do some chest flies with cables. Then after that, glute ham raises. I think I'm gonna program glute ham raises and dumbbell RDLs on this day. I may not be able to go through both since I'm on a time limit, but just letting you know so that you know.
Run on me no more, because I'm real inside, you'll never feel this vibe. We never get it right, we ignore. But still I try till the day I die to throw away my pride and be pure. But what I came here for is to relate to your divine force, the orator. The story tells, so I hope we gel, and you can send email, I'm on tour. Don't.